It's a great pleasure and privilege for me to be here in Shillong, the historic city with which my own district, Sylhet, is inextricably linked for a number of years. So it's always a pleasure to be here. It's almost like homecoming. As a son of an Assam civil servant whose other half of family lives on the Karimganj side of Assam, I have a very special soft corner for this province as well as for the Northeast region. Since I had the privilege of talking about the connectivity issues between Bangladesh Northeast as well as between Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Myanmar under the auspices of BBIN, BCIM, BIMSTEC, etc., only 2 months ago. So I will leave it to our two honorable ministers who are here to kindly speak in detail regarding Bangladesh's position on these connectivity questions. I would just like to make a few points to emphasize the importance of river for this region. As you all know, these South Asian countries, which occupies only 3.4% of the global land space, houses 25% of the world's population. So with 3.4% land of the world and 25% of the world's population, we have a major challenge. And that challenge we have been able to face for the last so many years because of our fertile alluvial soil and the constant supply of water, which is provided by more than 100 rivers which crisscross our territory. These rivers are unique in many respects. They provide the very necessary requirement for our survival, for the production of our grain, for our existence in this world. Bangladesh, for example, roughly with the size of Wisconsin, sustains half of American population. Likewise, all the South Asian countries have definitely achieved a great progress in the areas of agricultural production as well as for the development in the entire region. But at the bottom of everything is water and the fertile soil. But the fertile soil without the water will become unfertile very soon. So we are dealing with a quarter of humanity, and the question of the survival of the river is not only for the promotion of tourism or trade or for culture and for other purposes, but for our own survival. And I think we should emphasize this issue in very clear and categorical terms. Prime Minister Modi, during his visit to Dhaka, had very kindly emphasized the point when he said, there are three things which you cannot stop. And as Shripriya is here, she would kindly bear me out. One of them is Pakshi, one is Pavan, and most importantly, Pani. So we cannot compartmentalize the river. We cannot decide that we will be only responsible for the river, for the part that it flows to our territory. River requires sustained management, river requires joint basin management, and requires constant nourishing and constant treatment. The sooner we understand this, the better we do. Otherwise, we can learn from various sad experiences of the world, particularly, for example, in the Aral Sea, which has died during the last 20 years. Aral was the third largest freshwater lake in the world, but due to misuse of the river, Aral Lake has dried up. And today, all efforts have been made to revive Aral, but unfortunately, Aral is dead forever. So before it is too late, let us try to save our rivers. Surely, with the need for faster rate of development, we have gone for industrialization. For industrialization, we have also sometime gone for hydroelectric stations or even barrage projects to augment our agricultural production. But that has to be done in a very systematic and planned manner. Otherwise, there are many projects in our South Asia which were built with a lot of expectation, but they have never produced the results which the original planners had desired. So before we deal with this subject, it is better to take a comprehensive approach. And as my counterpart has just emphasized, there are several institutional bodies which we have built during the recent years, like BBIN, BCIM, BIMSTEC, and others, for joint basin management as well as for augmenting production hydroelectric power through this joint cooperation. Thirdly, I would like to mention that rivers also need constant care. When I stand before these rivers of Assam, I feel sorry, because as a young boy, I stood with my father on the banks of these rivers, and some of these rivers were as big as the oceans, and ocean-going vessels used to operate on those. In fact, that is the starting point for the facilities immigration to the UK, is by acquiring necessary experience in serving in those vessels. Today, as I stand before those rivers, the channels have become so narrow that only small launches can only go through. Let us try to revive our rivers. Let us try to use these rivers to promote trade, tourism, as well as for the connectivity question between our people. This has been the case for the last so many centuries. During the last 68 years, we have created these new obstacles. The sooner we remove these obstacles, the better we do. And I think this meeting would kindly give guideline to that effect. At the end, I would just like to emphasize that in consideration of the importance of this issue, we should try to organize greater degree of awareness among our people, particularly among the people, those who are directly involved in our socio-economic development, to give due importance to the question of river and the question of water in our future development. As regards the other connectivity issue, I think I have discussed in detail last time, Honorable Chief Minister, I would kindly recall, regarding the surface transportation as well as the rail communication. I have said that the rail communication between Northeast and our part of the world was always through the rail, and the rail has been the most economic, and it has been the most environmental friendly and cost-effective means of transportation. Up to 1965, the rail connectivity between Sylhet as well as with Northeast, I think, went uninterrupted. In 65, these points were disrupted, and we are now trying to revive those 6 points about which our High Commissioner of India has just mentioned. I hope the sooner we can restore them, the better we do. Likewise, I would also emphasize the need for air connectivity between Bangladesh and Northeast India. In today's world, people do not want to spend 12 hours for going from Shillong to Dhaka. They would like to go there in 45 minutes by an aircraft. Why would they spend 12 hours? So I think here, the government airlines will have to subsidize the initial cost of operation. Once they become viable, once they become profitable, then only it can be handed over to the private companies. Otherwise, like the bus service which we introduced 2 years ago, is not exactly functioning properly, because these are not as yet cost-effective and these are not yet viable. So initially, I think the government subsidy will be needed, but eventually, this will become viable and in future private parties will come. So our Honourable Minister, I'm sure, will speak at length on these issues. So I don't want to take more of your time since there are two more ministers from Bangladesh who are here. But our presence here only emphasizes the importance that we attach to this question. So I wish this conference every success and thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, sir.